places to find your increases. Good over evil is our evidence.
In the world.
Yes, but a couple of hundred miles away up the M6, some very different but no less passionate gardeners are taking a stand of a rather different sort.
Meet the A-team, or that's the allotment team to their friends. They're a ragtag collection of eco-warriors, foodies and concerned parents. Now they're defying the authorities to claim private land that they believe belongs to the people.
Claiming squatters' rights, these guerrilla gardeners are fighting their local council, who they say are depriving them of land promised for allotments. Well, taking matters into their own hands, they're digging in, determined to clear and cultivate this entire plot of land.
We come in peace, they said, to dig and sow. We come to work the lands in common and to make the waste grounds grow. This earth divided, we will make whole. So it will be a common treasury for all.
If we cultivate this land's then not going to waste. It's not. It's been like this for 8 years, and it's a crime, really.
So why is it important that you come and dig this soil?
I think it's important to be, particularly with the kids, to be introduced them to growing their own vegetables.
Will it be exciting to eat the vegetables that you grow, that you've actually grown?
Because it's free.
Because it's free. Good point.
The site on Ashton Moss near Manchester was promised for 70 allotments over 10 years ago, after a nearby motorway was widened, wiping out hundreds of existing plots. But after the work was finished, nothing happened. Now, every Saturday, local residents turn up with their own shovels and spades. It's part of a wider movement of so-called guerrilla gardeners, who illicitly clean up and cultivate land in urban areas they believe are being neglected.
So Nigel, why now? Why are you doing this now?
Why now? Because we've lost patience with the council. We've been waiting over 7 years. I do think that whoever is responsible for allowing this land to lie undeveloped, uncultivated, is negligent. The land has degraded. That's why we're actually taking positive action to bring the land back into cultivation, and we're improving it.
What business do you have bringing heavy machinery up? This is not a few chaps with a few spades, is it?
No, what we are doing is showing the landowners and the council that we're serious about cultivating this land.
It seems the would-be gardeners are caught up in a bureaucratic nightmare, with no one certain what the land's intended use will be.
The One Show asked to interview someone from the council so that they could clarify their position, but they declined to put anybody forwards. We also asked to interview the agents who act on behalf of the landowner, but they too declined to speak on camera.
The council did tell us they fully support the need to provide allotments in the area, but the site in question is owned by the developers. The landowners told us that negotiations with the council are ongoing, and they were hopeful a positive conclusion would be reached in the short term. Allotment expert Dave Morris has seen similar problems across the country.
We've just completed a recent survey, and that showed something like 150,000 people in the country on waiting lists for allotments. If you add to that the fact that over the last 10 years we've lost on 5,000 to 10,000 allotment plots, mainly to development, where they've been sold off.
So what's your take on what's going on here?
What needs to happen now is that we come to get together with the developer and the council and the people here and try and sort it out. Because the trouble is, you see them separately. Developer blames council, council blames developer. You'll make no progress.
The residents I've met today are clearly dedicated to what they're doing, but they are, after all, on private land, and this could see them eventually forced off.
How would you feel if you did get evicted and all this work was for nothing?
It hasn't been for nothing. It's as simple as that, really. We're doing it and we'll continue to do it, and if they kick us off here, then we'll have to kick us off somewhere else, because we're having allotments in Ashton Allotment.
Aunt Christine walked in is here, hiding behind lots of plants. You've hot-footed it over from Chelsea. Now, what do you make of that little film there?
I actually think it's fantastic. I think land just laying vacant and not being utilised. You know, we've got hundreds and thousands of people wanting allotments in this country. Yeah. For goodness sake, let's have a bit of common sense. You know, engage with it. If they need it back in 10 years, okay. But if it's going to sit there doing sweet Faddy Adams for years, you know, let's use it, give people pleasure, let's have food being produced and utilise the resources instead of just standing there like a tip. Now, good luck to
them. Yeah. What do you make of these statements?
Picked up the pieces to find your increases. Good over evil is our evidence.